Welcome to this video showing you how to rotisserie chicken in front of a chiminea. Of course, the technique will apply for a barbecue as well. We're starting out with a corn-fed chicken, and I've already put it on the spit. Just try to make sure that it's as even as possible so that we don't have any problems with it rotating. And I'm just organising my rotisserie now. Going to take a couple of moments and a little bit of care to make sure that my chicken is right in front of the heat. I've got my drip tray in place and I'm going to start the rotisserie running. I've built up a really nice heat here with the wood burning down. I'm only using oak, but really you can use any hardwood that you wish. It's not going to contribute any flavour, but just give good heat. The simple setup I have here, I made myself with some metal struts, but really you could use anything you like. These were just leftovers from a construction. And I use a firm piece of wire just to make sure that my rotisserie motor doesn't move too much. And it's all a matter of time with this. I've got to make sure that I keep my fire hot. That's really the key. I've got something on the top of the chimney just blocking the majority of the heat going straight up out the top. My chiminea came with a lid, so that works perfectly, and I just leave a small gap so that at least it can exhaust a little bit through the chimney. And as the chicken starts to cook, you can see the juices forming. And it's these juices that are going to really help make this chicken a lovely, flavoursome and tender piece of food at the end of the day. You can see why the drip tray is important, and you'd be surprised how quickly it starts to drip as well. So for the avoidance of arguments or damage to anything that you like, put a drip tray in place. And relax, because there's nothing much you can do to rush this. This isn't a rush job, it's just for pleasure. We're a couple of hours into this cook and you can start to see the juices are forming almost a crust on the skin, and those bits are really going to taste good. During the rotisserie, occasionally you want to perhaps just alternate the direction in which the chicken rotates. Some rotisseries will do that automatically. Sometimes you have to just press a switch and make sure that it does it for you. My rotisserie motor will change direction each time you power cycle it. Or if it reaches a point where it can't turn because of the weight. So do make sure you keep an eye on the counterweight and adjust as the cook progresses if need be. There's nothing special about my spit or rotisserie motor. Even some gas barbecues would be supplied with these, and there's no reason why you can't adapt. And as day gives way to night, it's quite a nice place to be. You would have noticed that your chicken's legs and wings moved quite freely at the start of the cook and then became stiff. But a way of knowing that your chicken's very nearly cooked is to keep an eye and look out for those legs to start moving, and wings particularly. I've even known them to drop off. So I've left my chicken to rest, 10 or 20 minutes, cook time of about 2.5 hours, and I'm really pleased with the way this looks. Beautifully moist, tender. His wings actually just given way on me. I hope you've enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.